This video is about safety considerations. Before watching this video, there are two things you should know. First, the information in this video is not legal advice. Consider calling a lawyer who understands domestic, sexual, and stalking violence. Second, if you or your family feel unsafe, call 911 or a trained victim advocate. Advocates can help you make a personalized safety plan. They can also help you understand the process at your local courthouse. Some advocates are mandatory reporters. This means they have to call Children's Services if they learn that someone is in danger. If you are worried about this, ask the person if they are a mandatory reporter before you tell them your story. See the links at the end of the video to find an advocate or lawyer in your community. A protection order can be a powerful tool to help you get safe and stay safe. But there may be times where a protection order is not the safest option. This video will describe some safety risks to consider before you apply for a protection order. One type of risk is increased violence. It is common for an abuser to become more violent when the victim ends the relationship. Even if the victim has tried to leave the relationship before, an abuser may only think the relationship is over when the victim seeks legal help. So, it is very important that you work with an advocate to make a detailed safety plan before you file for a protection order. You may be at an increased risk if your abuser has seriously injured you, threatened to hurt or kill you, strangled or choked you, stalked you, hurt or killed pets, suffers from depression or other mental health issues, struggles with alcohol or drugs, or has guns or other weapons. Even if the abuser has not done any of these things, you may still be in serious danger. Trust your intuition. Consider calling an advocate to talk about your situation and get help. Another type of risk involves harm to children. Filing for a protection order can lead to unplanned results. Although protection orders can cover children, there is no guarantee this will happen. There are many complicated factors that a judge must consider. In the end, a judge may choose to exclude your children from the order, or include them on the order, but still allow the abuser to have time alone with them. Ultimately, you may feel that the judge's decision does not protect your family. Please talk to a lawyer who understands domestic violence and the risks to children. If you are involved in any other legal cases, filing for a protection order can lead to unplanned results. For example, it could affect the outcome of a criminal case that is pending against you or the abuser. It could also impact a divorce or custody case, even if that case is over and does not involve your current abuser. If you have been involved in any legal matters, talk with a lawyer who understands how protection orders can affect other legal cases. There are other situations where a protection order could expose you to harm. If you identify as lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, queer, or similar, your sexual orientation and gender identity could become public. If you are an immigrant, your ability to stay in the U.S. may be affected. If you have an active warrant for your arrest, the police could arrest you. If you are struggling with homelessness, drugs or alcohol, or mental health issues, your right to see your children may be affected. Advocates and lawyers who are trained in domestic, sexual, and stalking violence can help you determine the safest options for your situation. There are many options where lawyers can help you for free. A local advocate can help you access these programs. Here are some resources that can help you find an advocate or lawyer near you.